So my question is, when you test your findings, how do you choose the neighborhood to test it? Is it going to be a downtown neighborhood or a midtown neighborhood or a suburban neighborhood? Because if you only test on one or two of them, you risk the, okay, there's the tendency to not find out how other neighborhoods will step in.
Thank you very much. Part of the first phase of the project was to look across a wide range of different environments in Toronto, and that included areas across the whole of the downtown and also places like Military Trail. That part of the project was used for us to identify key characteristics that you'll find across much of Toronto, because what's important is, and I think this is the point you're making, what's important is that the system is extendable and that you've anticipated the different challenges that are required in different places. A more suburban centre, for example, doesn't require the same density of signs that you'd require in a downtown area. The need for wayfinding is different for local people because they tend to know their local area, so they'll be looking for different things. Although we've not presented the details of any case studies, part of the original project was taking those principles and then applying them to test the concepts on a couple of areas that were very diverse in order to give us an understanding of the different types of wayfinding challenges, and also to test whether the conceptual principles that we've got around the room today in practice would work, and also to give us an understanding of how many signs we would need and how they would be placed and where they might be placed. So the next phase would be to establish for the pilot, in agreement with multiple stakeholders, one or two representative areas of the city where the wayfinding strategy can be tested in practice on street. Things that you'd be looking for would be, you might be looking for example, a subway exit. You might be looking for some key landmarks and cultural places, some retail, some residential areas, parks. So if you're looking for a few key characteristics, ideally you might look to try and find somewhere where there are roads that go off the regular north-south grid, where it makes it a little bit more challenging to navigate. So I think where Front Street hits onto Wellington, that could confuse a few people. They expect the whole of the downtown to be kind of directly north-south, east-west. And then they're walking on Front Street and all of a sudden they're going kind of southwest. So we will look at the city and the city form and the types of activities that are undertaken in different parts of the city and agree with various stakeholders to pilot areas to test on. It is a challenge, but that's what we're doing.
So now I'll encourage you to ask your questions directly. Come up to Phil, come up to myself, to Fiona, to Kristen, to all the people from the consultant team and the city and the steering committee, and make sure that you also use the comment sheets. Make sure that you sign in so that we are able to let you know when there's a draft document that you can have a look at when we're posting these things, and also put your comments onto the panels. And in closing, and then Fiona, you want to say something, but I really want to thank you all for coming. I won't have the opportunity later on to thank you. But this is a very important part of our process of testing the strategies, seeing if what we're coming up with makes sense, if it resonates. When we'll walk away today and we'll get a sense of, you know, these things seem to be resonating and making sense. Some of these we need to think through a little bit more, or we might need to rationalize in a different kind of a way if we're going to be pushing them forward. And it's a really important part of our process. So I really want to thank you, and I really look forward to all of your comments at that point. Thanks.
Thank you very much.